the names of the first men hanged here in Melbourne town. Tunnerminnerwait and Maulboyheener wouldn't bow before the crown. In January 1842, 5,000 stood on Bowen Street with a twisted sense of justice amid the cheers, dust and heat. Far from their ancestral homes down in Van Diemen's land, they knew their lives would be in vain if they didn't take a stand. And Tunnerminnerwait's first memory was the slaughter of his kin when the war of dispossession landed at Cape Grim. Maulboyheener would have led his clan if he ever had the chance, and he saw all the bloody suffering for the settlers' advance. All the redcoats and the convicts tried to wipe them out with lead, sent their black line across the island saying no one would be spared. Tunnerminnerwait and Maulboyheener, your names will be remembered. The warriors went with Robinson on the friendly mission trail, spreading word among the people, to survive we must set sail. And so many struggle to remember what was friendly anymore. 15 went with Robinson to the Port Phillip colony, where they called him chief protector of aborigines. And they helped with making contact when no white men had been. But lost faith in protection, as of the living hell it seemed. But the spirit of resistance could no longer be suppressed. Raiding stations across Western Port, as history will attest. With no harm to women or children over an 8-week long campaign, they set fire to the grain. Tunnerminnerwait and Maulboyheener, your names will be remembered. Tunnerminnerwait and Maulboyheener, your names will be remembered. A minor Watson's son got hit, and they were surely out to kill them, cause they never could commit. Reclaiming of the land they stole from the native dispossessed, so they sent out every troop of horse and tracker to the nest. And as they waited for the they saw two figures in the dark, yet they couldn't tell they were whalers, for their bullets made their mark. Oh, they had every reason to fear men like this, with their memories of the past. the hand that steered the mast. And as the troops began their awful siege, they fought off every round. By some miracle, five survived, huddled on the ground. The three women were acquitted, and the men condemned to die. An example must be set, said the judge, lest other rebels try. And as they lay the fighters in the ground, they hoped their names would quickly fade. But lest we forget the heroes and the sacrifice they made, will they remind us there's more to do if